In this video, I'm going to show you how to take an object out of an edge-to-edge pattern if it's not something that your customer wants. For example, let me load in this baby pattern. Close that and I'll make it bigger. Say for example, and I actually had this happen, lady really loved the look of this baby pattern, but she absolutely refused to have anything that had a nuck or a binky in it. She just did not believe in kids using them, so she didn't want them stitched in her pattern. Another example I've had, like fall leaves, and there's an acorn, and they want me to take the acorn out of it, so it's just leaves. So this can occur occasionally. So let me show you what you can do. Let's scroll into it and take a look at where the nuck is located. The first thing that we want to do is actually cut the nuck out of the pattern. To do that, we can use the split function. We go up to split. We want to do two. So we're going to do multi-segment. And we're going to say, okay, let's cut it there. And let's cut it there. That's where the lines are going in to the nuck and out of the nuck. Once we say accept, you'll notice that now if I go to transform and highlight the nuck, it has become its own separate pattern. So we don't want that. We're going to right click on it and delete. Now, we don't want to leave the pattern as it is because number one, it's going to start and stop in the middle of the pattern and leave what looks like kind of a big hole there. So what we want to do instead is to join those lines. And to do that, we're going to go back into ABC, draw, and highlight. You notice it'll only let you work on this as sections. And in fact, it doesn't even highlight the entire section on this one. So we're going to scroll in here, and we know this is our start point because that one's red. This one has to be green. So we're going to pull it over and possibly make it, say, the bottom of an arc. We're going to right-click and hit Arc. And that might be too much of an arc, but we're going to click back on this one and bring it down. Possibly bring the next one down a little bit farther. Actually, we're going to bring that one down. We're going to bring that one down. And we're going to swing this one around and set the two points on top of each other. I'm going to right click on my line and force it to be an arc so I get kind of a loop looking. And as well, if I make this one an arc, or if I make this one was an arc, but it was a little bit bent too quickly. Back off and take a look. That's not too bad looking. What's a little bit kludgy is this area up in here. So again, I'll click on it. And you notice it's full of a lot of arcs there. So we can go down into our edit function here and say delete points. And now as I click on points, it's going to actually delete them. The one main thing to remember here is you've got to take yourself out of delete points to be able to do anything other than delete points. So we're going to right click and say arc. Kind of smooth that out a little bit. Pull that back. And I don't think that looks too bad. We've got a little bit too much of an open space here. So we could go back into it and basically draw our points down a little bit farther. Bring this point down a little farther. And I would say possibly adjust that so it's not quite so strict. There. We've now replaced a loop into the place where that nuck was so that there's not an empty looking space. The other thing we could have done is put a different object in there. If we'd have had another baby style object, there's quite a few things in here, like maybe a balloon. We could have taken a balloon pattern, put it in there, and connected it up. The last thing we need to do is we need to finish that connection because there's still a start and stop there that it will stop at. To do that, we're going to use the end snap function. When you use end snap, it shows any connections as purple squares. You'll notice the start and stop are slightly less purple, but where there is a stop and a start on top of itself, there will be a darker square. So all we're going to do is left click on it, drag it slightly, and let go. What that ends up doing then is connecting those two points together, and we have totally modified our pattern. Now, we would probably want to save the pattern, and let's take a look here. If I go to save pattern, thankfully it doesn't have the name of the original pattern. It has actually the name of the last function that I used. But make sure, had it had the name of the previous pattern, that you don't overwrite it, because then you would lose the pattern that has the binky in it, and somebody else may like the binky. So make sure that you give it a name that's totally different than the one that was there, or append to the end of it to say without the nuck, or whatever you want to say. But that's what you'll want to do to save this pattern, or call it new baby edge to edge, and hit save. Now it's a pattern ready to use. Hopefully you found something you can use from this video. You can find much more information on using the design functions of the AutoPilot's Mach 3 software in our self-study training book with matching videos entitled Be Creative with Your Mach 3. This course is available on our website's online store at foreverinstitches.com. Thank you.